we have to add and reduce to the lowest terms. We have here algebraic fractions. How we add algebraic fractions? The same like we add fractions. It means we need to have the same denominator. We have y and x, and first we have number. We can always change the number to a fraction. I can just put 1 over 1 is 1. And the rest we will copy. Next, like I said, we need to have the same denominator. In the denominator we have 1, y, and x. So the least common denominator for 1, y, and x will be y times x. Because when I multiply by 1, it didn't change anything. It still will be yx. And I will change, I will first put x and next y. We always put in the alphabetic order variables. And let's check. Canon denominator, it means, must be number or expression which is divisible by every denominator. Is divisible by 1, is divisible by y, and is divisible by x. So it is the least common denominator. And next, when I change this fraction to denominator, I need to have xy. It means I have to multiply this one by xy. When I multiply denominator by xy, I have to do the same with the numerator, because I cannot change this expression. When I have multiplication, when I reduce this, I still have 1 over 1. 1 over 1 is 1. So I have still the same what I have at the beginning. I only change now this denominator to xy because I need to add this to algebraic fractions. And to add algebraic fractions, I need to have the same denominator. Next algebraic fraction, we have y in denominator. We need xy. So I have to multiply this denominator by x to get xy. If I multiply denominator by x, I have to multiply numerator by the same variable. So now we have yx is xy. And here we have only x, so I have to multiply by y this denominator. If I multiply denominator, I have to do the same with the numerator. Now we can do multiplications. We have 1 times xy is xy, and 1 times xy is xy. So this is our first expression. Xy over xy is 1. Next we have plus. In the denominator we have y times x. This is xy. I just put these two variables in the alphabetic order. And we have numerator x times x is this is x squared. And we have plus xy in the denominator. And z times y is yz. First I put y. And now this is equal. We have the same denominators, so I will copy denominator xy, and we can add now these numerators. We have xy plus x squared plus yz. Next we have to check if we can reduce something, because we have addition in numerators, so we have to check if we can factorize something. We have xy, x, and yz. Every term is different, so we cannot factorize anything. This is my solution.